So I am going to write the Spark code in Python for one of the very famous use case book recommendation system. So we use the Spark ARS alternating list square, but I would recommend please visit my previous video where I have already explained what is the recommendation system and what are the different kind of recommendation system, collaborative factors, matrix factorization, all those things. And please subscribe my channel, it motivates me a lot. Let us start. So what I am going to open one terminal. So in that terminal, let me start my Jupyter notebook. Okay, so there are many ways to start Jupyter notebook. I have configured this way, so you can take, now you can see that I have started the Jupyter notebook, right? I don't have anything, I have just the data set I have. I will expand the data set also. Let me start one new file, and I can say that book and first I said go here and download the the data set. What is the data set? Let me explain you. In if you see here, if you come the book recommendation, so this is the data set. It have the main three files, rating.csv, then books.csv, and then the to read.csv. So in rating.csv, what is there? It has the book ID, user ID, and how much they have given the rating. I will show you in the code. And the CSV has the book ID, book name, title, and many other things. And the to read is the, this is the wish list kind of things. They have the user ID and the book ID. That will be explained in detail, right? So let us start the code. And first implement all the required libraries, right? So let me just copy paste. These are the required libraries. Then once you do that, I will explain each and everything where it is required. This is the SQL context. If you need the SQL, I will show you where it is required. And this is the regression evaluator, when you create the model with how to evaluate with the validation data and find out that root square mean, that we can do that. And the cross validator, it is a common concept in machine learning. If you want to set the different kind of parameters for the tuning parameters for your model, then how you can use that. And then this is the most important, the ARS, what I was discussing that, right? Now what I'm going to do that, I'm going to start the Spark, and this is the way to start the Spark on Jupyter notebook. So you have to first use the Spark session with the PS I have imported here, and then py Spark, right? And then we create the context, Spark context and the SQL context. Okay, so once it start, then let me, what I'm going to do that I will import our data set. So we have the one, as I said, we have the two data set. One is the rating and there is a book. So this is the command spark.read.csv. It will download your things and make the data frame. So I have given the name rating_df, the data frame. Let me explain why these two are the important. This header is equal to true, it will download the header name also for the CSV, and it is important because our lot of logic is depend upon the header name. And what is the infer schema? So it can convert even your data in the number, but as a string, they will convert into the integer. Okay, so let me execute that. It will show what are the different columns are there in this rating df. So we can see we have the three columns, book ID, user ID, and the ratings, right? You want to see, you can, I can also show few datas. Okay, so this is the data, right? Five data. I showed the five data. Now the same way we can take the book also. Okay, so take the book also, and these are the different columns in the book, right? Let me show the book one data. Let me show you, so you can understand what are the different things are there. So they have the use information, the ID, book ID, best book ID, all those things. We no need to all those things. Just we need the title. We need the title. What is the book name? And we use the image URL. So I can download the image and show here. It should be here. This image URL, right? So once you get it, now I have to split our training data set into two part: testing and validations, right? So let me copy those command for saving our time. So here what I did, I take the all those things will be work on the rating dot rating CSV. Okay, only for getting the name and the image URL we will use the book CSV, but most of things it will work for the rating dot CSV, right? So now we split the data. You can see I have given the, this is my main data, rating dot df, and I am giving 0.8.2, means 80% is the trading data and 20% is the validation data, right? So now if you get it, now the important part, these are the tuning parameter that I am going to use it. I explain you, and in my previous video also there, what is the iteration, and in my previous video I have terminology lambda, this one, and rank is most important things. You must should know what is the rank in the, and I have very detailed explain what is the rank in my matrix factorization video. Must watch it. What is the, to understand what is the rank. This is very important terminology in the ARS, right? So we are going to use in my when you create the model, right? And now this is the things we are going to create the model. So you see, ARS is the algorithm name. How many iteration you want? So as I have already explained in my previous video, what happened when you have the big matrix, we want to divide it in matrix into the two part, okay, with the help of the rank. Suppose if you have the rank 2, then with the two rows and two columns, all those I have explained. And then iteration is that, like the gradient descent, how many backward forward should be there to adjust the tuning parameter to get your, to minimize the errors, right? This is the lambda value. This is the 0.1 I have taken. So each iteration, how much point you want to change, right? Rank I have explained. You have to watch the video to get detail about. And what are the columns name? So I have explained. If you see here, my column name is the book ID and the user ID. So the same I am giving here, user ID and the book ID. Okay. And the rating column, this is the column name is the rating, that is also there here. Okay, now I will pass the training data and fit. This is a machine algorithm concept. So what it will do, it will take this training data and create the model, right? And this is my model. Once my model is created, I will pass my validation data to check how much score is there for the model, what is the accuracy of there. So it will return the prediction. I will delete all the prediction. In this prediction df, we will have the column name prediction. So if any prediction is null, I will remove that, and then the new prediction column. Then we will check evaluate how much error is there. So that's why we use this regression evaluator, pass the RMSE root mean square error. You must be knowing that. And then we see how much error is there. Let me execute this. This is the important part. You should know this piece of code. This is the heart of this the complete coding what I'm going to do today. Okay, so it might take some time, but you see, I have taken that rank four, and if you see, I have taken the rank four, I have taken the alpha, lambda is 0.1, and iteration is 10. So these are the hyperparameter for the ARS model. So you have to keep changing this value to get the best model, then you can execute the further your code. Okay, so if you see, it has been executed and the mean square value is 0.89. so do one thing, take the same code and execute for the rank 5 same code and see which is good one. So then you can select it. But you so how you can check one by one, right? So for that, what I will do, I will make one for loop for the rank range 4 to 7, means 4, 5, 6, and for the each one they will execute and they will show that report, that for this rank what is the RMSE for this rank, and you should pick up the one which is the minimum less value, right? You can pick up that one. I'm not going to execute this code, you can do just copy paste from here and you can do in your own system, right? Now you can see for the 4 we got this one, and for the rank 5 we got this one. Obviously if you compare with this both, the rank 4 is giving the good one. Okay, but important thing is that I am only changing the rank. I am only changing the rank. What about this value? What about this iteration? So all the three you have to change. So a lot of permutation and combination you can get it. It will take a lot of time. That's why machine learning basic fundamental, you should do the cross validation concepts. So if you see the cross validation concept, what it says, it will do everything on behalf of you. So what you have to do, I will not execute the code because it may take more time. What I'm saying that the lambda value, you take the three different lambda value, and range, you take the range for the 4 to 10. So what happens, it will take the range 4 and execute for the 3 lambda. Again take the range 5, execute 3, and whatever the best model it will give to you. Okay, so for time being I am just going to use which one I used to use. Okay, I am going to use what the model I have already created, this model. Okay, but you can do this experiment in your house. So once it is done, then let me check, yeah, done this part. Okay, so now we have to, okay, so now we, our model is created, right? This model, take the model name, only model, we have not, or okay, take the model name, model. Okay, so now I am passing our validation data to predict. Whatever the validation data we have separated, you are going to predict on that data, right? That is a prediction. And what is the RMSE, we have already given that for this validation, how much for this validation set of data, what is the RMSE. Okay, so if we execute it, we give it, we see now it just showing the 10 prediction. So what it does, he took all the data of the validation DF 20% and showing, I'm just say the 10, just show the 10 data. This is the book ID. For this book ID, it is recommending this the user ID. Important thing is that this is the actual rating from the data set, and our model is predicting this prediction. So it is almost equal. 4, 3.8, 3.8, 3, 3.6, 3, 3.4. This is the actual and this is a prediction. So when you set the hyperparameter, you might get the good value here, right? So now next, what I will do, I want to show the name. So what I will do, this book ID is showing, but I want to show the book name. What is the book name for this? So what you have to do for that, we make the join concept is that I am going to join this prediction data frame into the book DF, what we have already done in the starting of this code, and name we have given the book DF. So it will join that. I am getting just 5 data. If you see, just show the 5, let it be from that. So now it will show, now you can see that it take the random user ID from the complete data set of the prediction, and this is user ID, this is the book name, and this is the prediction, right? So it was the predefined predictions it's showing, right? Now what I'm going to do, I want to see the prediction for one user ID. So I want to give this user ID, suppose take any user ID, in my code I have taken just random anyone. So what I'm doing that, try to understand, in this prediction I filter one user ID, okay, then I join with the books, okay. So what in this case, in this code we have the that randomly first five, but in this case I am saying no, for this user ID show me for one user, okay. So it is showing that for this user ID, what is the book name and the book title. Okay, this is the total count 2. Let me show you this one. So then, dot show. So now if you see, for this user there are the two books, for this user there are the two books, one book, second book, and the prediction is this, okay, this got from the prediction data frame. Now I want to see all the images for this book, right? So you can just click that. I have given the code base, you can use the same code base. Now it will show the book name and that the book image for that particular user, 35982 user ID. So you can see they are showing that. So now move to the another part of this ARS library. So now this is important. For all the user, how many user we have in my data set, I want to get the recommendation for all the user. So for the one user it could be 10, 20 recommendation, but I am restricting my code only for the five recommendation I want, but for all the user. And opposite case, for all the book I want to get the five user, understand? So first one, what it is showing, it will recommend the five book for all the user, and second code it is recommend the, it will recommend the username for all the books, understand? So let me execute this. Okay, I have changed the model name, model, so that's why it is happening. Then what we will do, we will let it first happen that. Understand, right? Recommend for all user. So for all the user I want to recommend five book, so this one will give that. Now I want to show that, so what I did, you see user recommends, take it here, I am showing the user ID and the book ID, okay. So it will show that user ID, book ID, and the same thing we will do for the book recommendation also. We did the for the user recommendation. Now let it be complete, then we will show the book recommendation, right? Taking time, so depends upon that the capacity of this one. If you have any questions, any doubt, please use the comment box, and I would recommend please subscribe my channel. I am giving a lot of effort to upload this video and making more easy to understand all of you. So now you see this, for the one user ID 148, the system recommend the five different books. This is a book ID. So for this 463, they are showing these five recommendation, right? So the same thing we can do for the book recommendation also, right? So it will show that. And why I have given this recommendation here, if you want to know, so do one thing, just go, okay, and create the print schema, right? Yeah. So if you click here, what happened? Print schema, user, recommends, should it work? Mistake schema, yeah. So this has the different hierarchy, that's why I have taken the recommendation. This recommendation is the same here, recommendation, right? In the recommendation we have the user ID, book ID. So this is book ID. So in this recommendation you can see we have the book ID. This is the book ID, right? Same thing you can see for this, the book recommendation. For this book ID we have the different user ID, right? So once we done that, then we want to do the very interesting thing. What we will do? So these are the API given by the Spark, right? ARS. These two important API. No, this API was the full for all the user, but that is not always useful. Why I want to know for all the user recommend, right? So if you want to some 3 or 5 user ID their recommendation. So what you have to do? First, you take any 3 users. So what I did, from the rating main data, I took the three random user ID. So I took this 3 random ID, and I want to know what is the recommendation for these 3 user ID, not all the IDs, right? So it is very easy. API is there. You use the model recommendation for user subset. It was here the recommend for all the users, but this API name is the recommend for the subset. So now you execute this and we can so that recommendation, right? So for all the 3, now you can see that for the each user ID they have given the 10 recommendation system, right? And we can do the same thing, or if you want to see the detail we can see in this way. So the same way we show that. Now you can see detail. 3 to 5, 9 to this 10. Why 10? Because I have taken the 10 recommendation. But for each user, I want the 10. Right? The second way we can do the same thing for the opposite. Means for these 3 books. So I took randomly 3 book. This 3 book ID. And I want to get the users, recommended users. So then you can these 2 things. So it will show for the each book, what is that? Now this is the book ID for this book, how many recommended users are there, right? So these are the very powerful command out there. Now the very important, suppose if you understand this much, then let me show one important thing. In that data set, we have one, open that with Excel. We have one 2_read.csv. That is kind of the wish list. So for this user, this is the wish list. So I will take the data from here, put into the model, and check how much their wish list is matching with my prediction. Right? This might be interesting. So for the coding, what I have done, I have taken this book ID for this user. So 4967. If you go and search the 49, so for this user 4917, I have taken the randomly 8. So if you see 8601524, 8601524, so this 8 I have taken, and same thing I will put in my model and see the predictions, right? This, so what I did here, I take the book ID, user ID, and create one data frame. That's why I need the SQL context top I was talking, right? Once you get it, then user predictions, okay, just I want to show. Yeah, so this is my data frame. This side is the book ID, this side the user. And let me push this data into our model. So our model name is the model, and transform when you want to model, when I put the data in this and check it. I think 26 minute video is too much big. Now you can see this prediction. So right, so this is the book and this is one. So you can see recommendation is good because they have taken the 2.45, 3.45. And if you go the data set for this user, they have given the recommendation between 3 to 4, right? So that's it for this one. Thank you. And please subscribe YouTube, my channel, right? And if you have any questions, let me know. Thank you very much. Bye bye.